Elisa is a most common diagnostic method which is used to detect specific antigens or antibodies present in our body. So whenever a pathogen comes into our body, so they release some chemicals. Such chemicals are known as antigens. So against to that antigen, our body produces some proteins called as antibodies. So the presence of antigen or presence of antibody both will determine that the person is suffering from or is infected. So ELISA is a very common diagnostic method we are using in pathological laboratory. Now I am going to explain ELISA. So it is a short form for enzyme linked immunosorbent assay. Enzyme linked in immunosorbent assay. This test is used for two purposes. One is if this test is performing for identifying the antigens, then it's said to be direct ELISA. So direct ELISA main intention is to identify the type of antigen found in the body fluids. And another one is indirect ELISA, in which based on antibodies we recognize the particular disease. So indirect ELISA is performed to detect the antibodies found in our body fluids. Now today I am going to explain direct ELISA method. Direct ELISA method, in that there are several methods are there, but in that competitive assay, one method, the competitive assay is a direct ELISA method which we are using for pregnancy test. Now I am going to explain how pregnancy test can be performed in the laboratory. Before that, a pregnant woman contains HCG molecules in her urine. So HCG stands for human chorionic gonadotropin. So HCG molecules present in the urine. So presence of HCG molecules in the urine determines pregnancy. If HCG molecules are not found in the urine sample, then we confirm that the lady is not conceived. Let us see how this pregnancy test can be conducted in the laboratory by direct ELISA, which we call it a competitive assay. Let us see competitive assay. Now for performing pregnancy test, we need antibodies for HCG molecules. So HCG molecules, when they form after pregnancy only, normal woman doesn't contain the HCG molecules, so that the normal woman does not contain even antibodies also. So that antibodies are pre-formed antibodies are available in the laboratory, so we require antibodies. And second one, enzyme linked HCG molecules, human chorionic gonadotropin molecules, which are coupled or linked with enzymes. So these are also available in the laboratory. And third one, substrate. So substrate is used to know the positive or negative results, like the color appearance. For the color appearance, we add the substrate. So by determine if the color appears, we say positive or negative, whatever it may be. So let us see here. So these three are required for performing the pregnancy test. So let us see case one. For example, this woman is not pregnant, so that means her urine does not contain any HCG molecules, right? So add the antibodies to this sample. Okay, so these antibodies cannot react with HCG because HCG molecules are not there, so that they are in isolate manner. Now add SCG molecules linked with enzymes to this same sample. So these enzyme, these antibodies are antibodies we added, and then later you add SCG molecules with coupled with enzymes. So these are, for example, SCG molecules coupled with enzymes. So when we add the SCG molecules to this sample, immediately these antibodies will bind with each and every SCG molecule, so that SCG antibody complex will form. Then add the substrate. So due to occurrence of SCG and antibody complex, this substrate will give color. So here this sample shows the color, hence we can say that no pregnancy. Color appearance indicates no pregnancy, because there are no natural SCG molecules. What we have added, antibodies. What we have added, SCG molecules coupled with enzymes. So because of these two complex, so color is appeared, so that no natural SCG molecule, so that she is not conceived, so no pregnancy. For example, case 2. So this lady or this woman is pregnant lady, just imagine. So the urine sample contains the natural SCGs, right? So when we add these antibodies to this sample, immediately these natural SCG molecules will couple or will bind with the added antibodies. Now antibody SCG complex will form. Antibody SCG complex will form. Later you add SCG molecules linked with enzymes. SCG molecules linked with enzymes. Already all the antibodies are connected with the SCG molecules available in the urine. So they are busy with this all the antibodies, so that no SCG molecule coupled with enzyme is ready to connect with any antibody or any antibody, because antibodies all are coupled with the SCG molecules available in the sample. So that when you add the substrate to this sample, no color appears, because this complex does not give any color. The complex enzyme linked SCG with antibody only will give color. So this natural SCG molecule and this antibody does not give color. So no color appearance. No color is nothing but pregnancy. So here what is happening? Binding of antibody, whether with a natural SCG or enzyme linked SCG, here there is a competition, like, so that it is called as competitive assay.